أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم प्यारे बच्चों अस्सलाम वालेकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहू। पिछले दिनों में हमने प्रॉफिटहुड इन इस्लाम के बारे में दो पॉइंट्स डिस्कस किए हैं। पहला पॉइंट था नेसेसिटी ऑफ प्रॉफिटहुड और दूसरा पॉइंट था एक्सेप्टेंस ऑफ प्रॉफिटहुड। आज हम तीसरा पॉइंट इसका डिस्कस करने जा रहे हैं, पढ़ने जा रहे हैं, दैट इज डिवाइन सैंक्शन ऑफ प्रॉफिटहुड। Almighty Allah Himself raises the two prophets. All prophets were divinely sanctioned posters. It is Allah who has sent them up to mankind to convey His message to His people. It is His command to repose faith in the prophets and to follow them. Thus, one who refuses to believe in Allah's messenger actually denies or refuses to follow Allah's commandments and becomes a rebel. There is no denying to the fact that one who refuses to acknowledge the authority of the viceroy of his sovereign actually refuses the authority of the sovereign himself. This disobedience turns him into a rebel. Allah is the Lord of the universe, the true sovereign, the king of kings, and it is the bounden duty of every man or every human to acknowledge the authority of his messengers and apostles and to obey them at his accredited prophets. And one who turns away from the prophet of Allah is surely a kafir. To be a believer of Allah or a disbeliever. The advent of a prophet is not an everyday occurrence, nor is the prophet essential for every land, people, and period. The life and teachings of the ascended prophet are the beacon light to guide people to the right path, and as long as his teachings and his guidance are alive, he is himself alive. The real death of a prophet consists not in his physical demise, but in the mitigation of his teachings and the interpolation of his guidance. The earlier prophets have died because their followers have adulterated their teachings, interpolated their instructions, and besmirched or dishonored their life examples by attaching fictitious events to them. Not one of the earlier books, Torah, Zabur, or Injil, etc., exists today in its original text, and even the followers of these books confess that they do not possess the original book. Judging the facts on this criterion, no one can deny that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his teachings are alive. His teachings stand uncorrupted and are incorruptible. The Quran, the book he gave to mankind, exists in its original text without the slightest alteration of letter, syllable, or title. The entire account of his life, his sayings, instructions, and actions is preserved with complete accuracy. Even after the lapse of 14 centuries, its delineation in history is so clear and complete that it seems as if we are seeing him with the eyes under our brows. The biography of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the prophet of Islam, in each and every matter of life is preserved, and his guidance and his life examples are a lesson and a right path for us to follow.